हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे लेट्स सी द ब्लड सप्लाई टू द हेड नेक एंड द फेस. सो द पेयर आर्टरीज विच इज मोस्टली सप्लाई टू द हेड नेक फेस दैट इज अ पेयर ऑफ वर्टिब्रल आर्टरी एंड अ पेयर ऑफ कॉमन कैरोटिड आर्टरी. सो द वर्टिब्रल आर्टरी इट इज ब्रांच ऑफ द सबक्लेवियन आर्टरी एंड द लेफ्ट कॉमन कैरोटिड आर्टरी इट इज द ब्रांच ऑफ डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम द आर्च ऑफ एओर्टा एंड द राइट कॉमन कैरोटिड आर्टरी इट इज द ब्रांच ऑफ ब्रैकियोसेफेलिक ट्रंक. Then the common carotid artery, it should be again divided into the external carotid artery and the internal carotid artery. The external carotid artery, it is supply to the superficial part of the head, neck and the face. And the internal carotid artery, it should be enters into the brain through the carotid canal which is present at the base of the skull. And the vertebral artery, it should be enters into that the skull through the foramen magnum. And this internal carotid artery and the vertebral carotid artery is into the skull, it should be forming the communication that is called the circle of Willis or circulus arteriosus. And this circulus arteriosus, it supply the blood to that the different parts of the brain. So let's see the details of the circulus arteriosus or circle of Willis. So the circulation of head, neck and the face. So the pair artery supplies to the head, neck and face. These are the common carotid artery. Here you can see. And next one, that is the vertebral artery. So this one. So that is the both arteries, common carotid artery and the vertebral artery. So let's see first, that is the vertebral artery. So this one. So here in this diagram, you can see that is the vertebral artery and the branch is coming out from the right and left subclavian artery. This one. So firstly, we should have to see that is the arch of aorta. So the arch of aorta, it gives majorly the three branches. First, that is the left subclavian artery, then left common carotid artery and the brachiocephalic trunk. Then the brachiocephalic trunk, it is again divided into the two branches. That is the right common carotid artery and the right subclavian artery. So the vertebral artery, it is the branch of right and left subclavian artery. So here in this diagram you can see that is the left subclavian artery and this is the right subclavian artery. And from this, that is the two vertebral arteries, they are originate. And these two vertebral arteries, they are passing from here in this diagram, you can see that is the foramina transversa of all cervical vertebra. So here you can see that is the C7 to C1 that consists of that the lateral side that the foramen is present. So throughout that the foramina transversa, these artery, vertebral artery throughout the foramen magnum. So here you can see that is the foramen magnum. The artery is enter into that the skull. So this is the right side vertebral artery and this is the left side vertebral artery. And these vertebral artery join to form the basilar artery. After then, let's see that is the common carotid artery. So here in this diagram, you can see that is the common carotid artery. So the common carotid artery, it is again divided into that the two branches. First, that is the external carotid artery, this one, and the internal carotid artery. So this one. So here in this diagram, again you can see that is the common carotid artery, here this one, and it should be divided. That is the external carotid artery and the internal carotid artery. So the internal carotid artery, it should be enters into the skull through the carotid foramen or the carotid opening which is present at the base of the skull. And then it is enter into that the skull and it should be helped to forming the circle of Willis. Then let's see that is the external carotid artery. So here in this diagram, you can see that is the external carotid artery and its branches. So the external carotid artery, it gives the several branches and that is supply to the superficial part of the head, neck and the face. So first, that is the branch, the superior thyroid artery. So here you can see, that is the superior thyroid artery. This artery, it is supply to the thyroid gland and the adjacent structure. Then second one, that is the lingual artery. So here you can see, this is the lingual artery, and it is supply to the tongue, the lining of mouth, tonsil and the epiglottis. Then the third one, it is the facial artery. So here you can see, this is the facial artery. So facial artery, it is supply to the muscles of the facial expressions. Then the occipital artery. So here you can see, that is the occipital artery. So it is supply to the posterior part of the scalp. Then the temporal artery. So the temporal artery, this one, or that is also called the superficial temporal artery. So it is supply to the frontal temporal and the parietal part of the scalp. Then next to it, the maxillary artery. So this one, so it is supply to the muscles of mastication, and the branch, middle meningeal artery, deeply supply to the structure in the interior of the skull. So these are the branches which is supply to the external part of the head, neck and the face. After then, let's see, that is the circle of Willis. So before starting the circle of Willis, here in this diagram you can see, that is the different branches of the external carotid artery which is supply to the head, neck and the facial region. So here you can see this one. So that is the common carotid artery, this is the external carotid and this is the internal carotid. So the branches of the external carotid artery. Then let's see the circle of Willis, or it is called the circulus arteriosus. So here in this diagram you can see the circle of Willis or the circulus arteriosus. So the circle of Willis, the greater part of the brain, it is supplied by the arrangement of arteries called the circle of Willis or the circulus arteriosus. So it consists of four large major arteries. That is, you know, that is the two internal carotid artery and the two vertebral arteries. So in the another diagram you can see, so that is the brain stem, this is the midbrain, this is the pons, this is the medulla oblongata, and that is the thalamus. So here in the another diagram we can see, that is the four large arteries. So in this diagram you can see, that is the two vertebral arteries, this one, and the two internal carotid arteries, so this one. So here you can see internal carotid artery, that is the two. So first, that is the vertebral artery. So as you know, that is the vertebral arteries are arises from the subclavian artery. Then it passes upwards through the foramina transversa. We had seen, that is here you can see, that is the vertebral artery, and it should be passing through the foramina transversa of the all cervical vertebra. Then it enters into that the skull through the foramen magnum, and the both artery, right and left side artery, it should be joined to form, that is the basilar artery. So this one, that is the basilar artery. Then second one, that is the internal carotid artery. So the internal carotid artery, this one, that is the branch of the common carotid artery, and that should be enters into the skull through the carotid foramen present on the base of the skull and enters into that the skull to help to form the circle of Willis. So here in this diagram you can see this one, both are the internal carotid artery. So and this four arteries, it should be contribute to forming the circle of Willis. So the structure is formed in such that is the brain as a whole receives an inadequate blood supply when the contributing these arteries. If any one artery it is damaged, so during this condition, that is the other arteries are continuously gives blood supply to that the nervine tissue of the brain, and that may be happen that is due to extreme movement of the head and the neck. Then let's see the branches of the circle of Willis. First, anteriorly the two anterior cerebral arteries, so this one, that is the two anterior cerebral arteries, these are arises from the internal carotid artery. So here you can see that is the internal carotid artery, and it gives that is a pair of arteries, that is the anterior cerebral artery. These anterior cerebral artery, they are joined with each other by the anterior communicating artery. So here you can see. Then posteriorly in this region, that is the two vertebral arteries, they should be joined to form the basilar artery. So here you can see. Then the basilar artery, it divides to form the two posterior cerebral arteries. So here you can see, these are the two posterior cerebral arteries, these two. Then each of which are joined to corresponding internal carotid artery. So here you can see, that is the posterior cerebral artery, it should be joined to that the internal carotid artery by the posterior communicating artery. So here you can see, that is the posterior communicating arteries. Then because of this, that is the anterior cerebral artery and the posterior communicating artery and the posterior cerebral arteries, so it should be forming that the circle like structure. So it is called the circle of Willis or the circulus arteriosus. Then it gives the different branches, that is two anterior cerebral arteries. So here you can see, that is the two anterior cerebral arteries. Then two internal carotid arteries, so this one, that is the internal carotid artery. Then one anterior communicating artery, so this one anterior communicating artery, and that is the two posterior communicating artery. Okay, so because of these artery, it should be forming that the circular structure, so that is called the circle of Willis. After then, we should have to see, that is the basilar artery. So this one. So the basilar artery, it gives the several branches. So first branch of the basilar artery, that is the superior cerebellar artery. This one. Then next to it, it gives, that is the small branches, that is called the pontine artery. Then below to that the pontine artery, it gives a pair of branches, it is called the labyrinthine artery, so this one. Then lower to it, there is presence a pair of artery, which is the large pair of artery, it is called anterior inferior cerebellar artery. So here, so these are the branches which is given by, that is the basilar artery. Then the vertebral artery, it again gives, that is the posterior inferior cerebellar artery. So here you can see. Then on medial side of the vertebral artery, that is it gives a single branch, and these two branches, it should be joined to form a single artery, that is called the anterior spinal artery. So this one. Then exact posterior to it, again vertebral artery, it gives a pair of branches, and these branches, they should be joined to form a single branch called the posterior spinal artery. So same, that is the mirror image of anterior spinal artery. So the different it course it gives, that is the it gives some small several branches. So first here you can see the anterior cerebral artery on medial side, it gives the branch that is called the medial striate artery. So here you can see MS means medial striate artery. Then lateral side of the anterior cerebral artery, it again gives a branch here R. So that is denoted recurrent artery of the Hebner. Then the middle cerebral artery, so this one, so it again gives a lateral side a pair of branches. So here that is the lateral striate artery. Medial to it, there is again give a branches. So this one, that is the anterior choroidal artery. Then the posterior cerebral artery, so this one here you can see, that is it gives lateral most side a branch, it is called the posterior choroidal artery. So this is the PC. Then the P denotes that the pontine artery, and that is the M, this one, it denote that is the medullary branches, so this one, and that is the MN, that should be denoted, that is the meningeal branches of the vertebral artery. So these are the small branches which are gives in the different parts of, that is the circle of Willis. After then we should have to see, that is the clinical application related with the circle of Willis. So the first clinical point related with the circle of Willis, that is the congenital cerebral aneurysm. So there occur mostly at the sites where, that is the two arteries join in the formation of the circle of Willis. So here, that is the two vertebral arteries here join, so there may be chances, or where, that is the two internal carotid artery, it should be forming or enters into that, the forming the circle of Willis. So in this region, that is the congenital cerebral aneurysm may be happen. So the basic abnormality at this point is the congenital deficiency of the tunica media, means that is the elastic tissue which is present into that the artery, they are absent, and the aneurysm are seen like the berry shape. So that is called the berry aneurysm. Then the next clinical point, that is the cerebral thrombosis. So here in this diagram you can see, that is the cerebral thrombosis, it is most commonly affect the middle cerebral artery. So here you can see, that is the middle cerebral artery, and the thrombosis means that is the formation of the clot of blood occluded into that the artery. So it is very commonly occurs in the middle cerebral artery or its main branches, because it is a direct continuation of internal carotid artery. So this one. So next, that is the subarachnoid hemorrhage. So the subarachnoid hemorrhage commonly, but not exclusively, result to form rupture of congenital berry aneurysm. So in the first clinical point we had seen, that is the congenital berry aneurysm, that is commonly occur where, that is the vertebral artery or the internal carotid artery, they are joined. So here, that is the rupture of the congenital berry aneurysm should be occurs in the interpeduncular system, and the subarachnoid hemorrhage that produces the sudden severe pain in the head followed by a mental confusion. Sometimes the death may be happen because of, that is the subarachnoid hemorrhage. Then the next clinical point, that is if one of the major artery of the circle of Willis forming the blockage into that the artery,
The circle of Willis provide various alternative routes for the collateral circulation, like an arterial traffic circle. So if any cerebral, middle cerebral artery is blocked, so that is the throughout that the through vertebral artery and the basilar artery, it should be supply blood to that the all parts of the brain. So there is no problem should be occur if any one artery should be blocked, and continuously blood supply is continue throughout the different part of the brain.
Then the occlusion of middle cerebral artery. So the occlusion of middle cerebral artery, it occurs the very commonly and produces the some symptoms. That is, first commonly symptoms are occur the contralateral hemiplegia and hemiasthenia, involving mainly the face, arm, due to involvement of mostly the primary motor and the sensory areas. Second one, that is the aphasia. So if left dominant hemisphere is involved due to involvement of motor and sensory speech area. And the third one symptom, that is the contralateral hemonymous heminopia due to involvement of optic radiation. So these are the three symptoms that should be seen when the occlusion of the middle cerebral artery is happen. So these are some clinical points related with the circle of Willis.